You are all aware we had the unfortunate incident of the theft from Kenya Forest Base Outpost in Kinyoro of two firearms. One was a she rifle. The she rifle is here. The theft occurred with 23 rounds of ammunition, and the 23 here displayed, as you can see, was stolen with 51 rounds of ammunition. A multi-agency team comprising of the National Police Service, Critical Infrastructure Protection Unit officers, Kenya Wildlife Service, Kenya Forest Service, National Government Administrative Officers, National Police Reservists, and the Directorate of Criminal Investigation mounted an aggressive security operation for the recovery of these stolen firearms. We recovered the she rifle from one suspect, Joseph Kimtai Nyongesa, 26 years old, at a place called Cholim in Embakasi County. When our officers confronted him, he fired at them. And of course, our officers fired back. He was gunned down. The body is still at the county hospital referral mortuary. Yesterday, after a series of security operations, we managed with the team, and after a tip-off from members of the public who have been assisting our officers on the ground with the intelligence on the recovery of these firearms, we managed to recover the G3 here with all 51 rounds. And once from Cherob Cave within Embakasi village in Kinyoro Division, Trans Nzoia, West Sub-County. Prime suspect, Bramwell Kibet Masai, 20-year-old, is in our custody. The Directorate of Criminal Investigation going on with investigations.
And also to thank God, and also to thank the Mount Agency security team who have been on the ground and who have really assisted in recovery of Kenya Forest Service firearms which we have stolen. Really, they have gone a notch higher, an overdrive, and also we want to thank the local leadership, also the current security team, and also the regional security team, which has also been very helpful, very supportive, and also the DCI headquarters, Nairobi, who sent a team to assist in the recovery of the firearm. Also, Kenya Forest Service appreciates the cooperation they have gotten from the community, from the leadership, the local leadership, whereby they have been able to volunteer information, as we told them on Wednesday, when we had the barasa, that they need to volunteer the information, so that now we can be able now to engage them, because we had said forest is a no-go zone from that time, because of the firearms being in the wrong hands. It can do a very great damage to the public. And really, we thank them for volunteering the information, which has led to the Mount Security team recovering the firearms. Now that we have recovered the firearms, we need now to state that we are now going now to start the investigation. Investigation has now commenced, and we urge them to volunteer even more information, because we know there are other firearms which are at large which are with the criminals, and we want to have them also recovered. So we are giving them a notice.